New on TV, All in the Family. On the big screen, The French Connection is the number one box office draw. Jack Nicklaus becomes the first golfer in history to record a double grand slam. Hank Aaron hits home run number 600 in April. Baltimore kicks a last-second field goal to beat Dallas in Super Bowl V. President Richard Nixon signs legislation giving 18-year-olds the right to vote. New car prices start at $4,000. Nearly everyone is wearing smile buttons. And in October, on the cover of two national magazines, the big news is Mickey Mouse and the opening of the Walt Disney World Resort in Florida.
Well, opening day was pretty amazing. My freshest memory, I think, was sitting in a grandstand over the railroad station, and Meredith Willson and the band from 76 Trombones marching out into the plaza from underneath us. And we all swore that the whole railroad station was going up and down with the sound of that band.
That magic moment is happening again 25 years later. 1,076 marching band members are creating new spine-tickling memories for another generation, parading on Main Street here in the Magic Kingdom Park.
Hi, everybody, I'm Regis Philbin. And just in case you can't tell, there's a big anniversary party going on right here at Walt Disney World Resort. A party you're invited to attend that goes on for an entire year.
The famed Magic Kingdom icon, Cinderella Castle, has been transformed into a giant anniversary confection with splashes of candy canes, red and pink icing, and 25 glowing candles to create the world's largest cake, 185 feet tall.
Actually, there are 26 candles, 25 for the anniversary and one to grow on. And Disney is growing, opening a new attraction here in the Magic Kingdom Park, Mickey's Toontown Fair, where youngsters can pose for pictures with Mickey and friends, or ride Goofy's Barnstormer or a new roller coaster. There's a special anniversary edition of Disney's popular nighttime spectacle, Illuminations 25 at Epcot. Lasers, fountains, and fireworks fill the night sky with colorful images of carnivals and celebrations around the world. Between Epcot and the Disney MGM studios, you can enjoy a brand new resort called Disney's Boardwalk. And in the months ahead, Test Track, an exhilarating new ride, opens in Epcot at the General Motors Pavilion. And that's just for starters, because Disney Imagineers are already thinking about where they'll be 25 years from now.
We might be out there in space somewhere, because by that time I think people will be living out there. That will be the next step. How do you entertain them? Figuring all that out would be a lot of fun.
And fun is what Disney does best. Stay with us for the next half hour as we remember the magic of the past 25 years and see how one man's dream changed the way America vacations and continues to define the ultimate vacation experience.
Remembering the magic, the Walt Disney World Resort, the first 25 years, is brought to you by
J&R Music and Computer World on Park Row, also celebrating their...
As you can see on this map, we have a perfect location in Florida, almost in the very center of the state.
Maybe you remember sitting down with the family every Sunday night and watching Walt Disney's Wonderful World of Color. You know, Walt's smile and gentle delivery was so genuine that his dreams became our dreams.
Here in Florida, we have something special we never enjoyed at Disneyland, a blessing of size. There's enough land here to hold all the ideas and plans we could possibly imagine.
Agents for Walt Disney spent nearly 2 years secretly acquiring ranch and swampland, 30,000 acres in all, before an enterprising reporter from the Orlando Sentinel broke the story.
I was down there as early as, if I remember correctly, 64. And looked at that land because it had been purchased well before Walt died in 66. There were a lot of swamps and a lot of sort of otherwise deserty looking areas.
We went out to what is now Discovery Island, which had only a hunter's shack on it, and the lake was terrible.
And the butterflies and the bees were flying around. I sat down, I said, come on, you gotta be mistaken that 10 million people are going to be driving by here, going up to that thing we're going to build up there.
All of our impressions were, if I could summarize it in one word, it'd be fear.
To help visualize Walt's plan, tethered balloons marked the spots where they would build the Magic Kingdom Park, Ticket and Transportation Center, and Disney's Contemporary Hotel.
And that was a bad moment. I thought, no, it's too big. It's too big, we can't do it. There wasn't enough ideas in the world to fill this place.
The land was big, 30,000 acres in all. By comparison, the Walt Disney World Resort is more than 180 times larger than Disneyland and twice the size of the island of Manhattan. Walt had a plan for this untamed land and began publicly testing his theory in 1964.
I think the New York World's Fair was a watershed for Disney in a lot of ways. In the first place, Walt wanted to test what he had done at Disneyland over a 10-year period in the kind of entertainment with an Eastern audience.
Well, a beautiful tomorrow, just a dream away. That says we're going places. There's progress ahead.
And that turned out to be terrific because out of the six or seven most popular shows, Disney had four of those shows. We tested a lot of new technology.
The actors, well, they're not real people, but they are a talented and interesting cast. We call them audio animatronic figures, and they talk and act like human beings.
This was really the baptism of audio animatronics because we did the General Electric carousel progress with the family changing through the years, the boat ride through Small World, and the People Mover came out of that because that's how we powered the Ford cars. And so there was a lot of groundbreaking that ended up being used as key parts of the shows for Walt Disney World.
Imagineers, that's a Disney-coined word for engineers with imagination, continued to create such exhilarating rides as the Tower of Terror, where guests plunged 13 stories down a pitch-black elevator shaft not once, but twice.
Rides like that bring some guests back dozens, even hundreds of times. How many times have you been to Disney World?
Three.
Five times.
And what about
five
you?
Five times.
Are you sure?
Yes, sir.
And what about you?
Three.
That's it, three. What do you like best?
That one.
Tower of Terror.
What do you like best?
Tower of Terror.
Yeah! But not everybody who comes here for the rides.
One of Disney's newest ventures in providing the ultimate vacation for demanding travelers with sophisticated tastes is the innovative Disney Institute. Here in a campus that resembles a rural artist colony, you may choose from dozens of hands-on learning experiences, like rock climbing, trying your hand at animation, or studying with master chefs.
There's another overused idiom today of, quote, pushing the envelope, but I really do believe that the advent of something like the Institute, where learning something as Disney connected as the art of animation to a lecture evening where Martin Scorsese was interviewed on the subject of sex and violence in his films. And that's about as far as you can go, seeing the image of Mickey, Minnie, Dumbo, and the group. I think of it as the most sophisticated buffet of entertainment one can have.
Great variety is important in keeping guests coming back year after year. But one of the nation's largest travel agencies says quality is equally important.
Certainly Disney has helped set the standards in the entertainment industry, particularly as it relates to attractions. And when you do visit Disney, you do understand that there's a certain kind of quality that people have come to expect every time they visit, and that quality stays unchanged. And that's why when people come, they know they will have the kind of experience that they're looking for.
We just love the entertainment, and every year there's something new, so each year you have to come back to see the new attraction.
The minute you go into that 30,000 acres, you are transported into a very secure, magical place that is fun for children as well as adults and anyone in between. It creates the ultimate family experience.
There's your horses.
I've got this really great granddaughter. She hangs out with me everywhere down here.
Bill and Vicki Meredith of Ashland, Ohio, first visited the Magic Kingdom Park in 1974 and returned with their families several times a year.
I'm getting an opportunity to see it from the ground up again. You know, when I can stick her on Small World and let her stand in front of the boat and act like she can sing the song, I think it's great. That's enough reason for me to love points right there.
And that's the real secret to our success. It's what Walt Disney said a long time ago. He said, everybody's a kid at heart. What you have to do is find a way to let them be one. Well, certainly Walt Disney World is that.
We had to wait in order to have a honeymoon, and we wanted to do it right, so we waited about 3 years and finally saved a little money to come down here to Walt Disney World.
I mean, I work all day. I have a lot of responsibilities. I work a lot of hours, and I have to be grown up and make big decisions all the time. And I come here, and it's just, I can be a kid, wear my ears, and it's just the best time I've ever had. It's great.
In 25 years, more than 500 million guests have come here to make their own special memories.
We believe Disney, and I believe Disney, was the biggest thing to ever happen to Florida tourism. When I came here with an airline, basically, it was just a small, sleepy town. We had Gatorland, which is still here and a wonderful attraction, and other small attractions, but it was nothing like it is today, and Disney did most of that.
According to figures kept by AAA, Orlando is the number one travel destination by car. In becoming the most popular vacation resort in the world, Disney's influence on Central Florida is, well, magical. 25 years ago, only 19% of the guests arrived by air. Today, that figure is well over 50%. 1 in 4 are from overseas. The world-class airport is new. The city skyline has changed dramatically in 25 years, and the population in the area has more than doubled to well over 2 million people. Coming up, we're going to take you to a place where cameras aren't normally allowed. Magic Kingdom's legendary underground city.
The kid and all of us, right, gang?
Yeah!
The music, the colorful floats, the festive atmosphere makes you want to break away from the curb and join in the fun. Let's go!
There's a party going on. That's where it is.
Each day, hundreds of returning guests will get to do just that as part of the special 25th anniversary parade. 25 years of magical Disney memories for millions of past guests are wrapped up in this musical spectacle. 6 giant floats serve as stages for a new kind of interactive street theater performance.
Okay, everybody, let's go!
Some guests of honors will get caught up in the conga line led by the dancing starfish from the Little Mermaid's Under the Sea float.
Oh, I just can't wait to be king.
One of my favorites is the Lion King float. Simba is riding high on Pride Rock, while his pals Pumbaa and Timon belt out another rousing chorus of Hakuna Matata. Preparations for this new parade began nearly 2 years ago, first as artist renderings that were later translated into physical realities.
On the finale float, for instance, we have a lift that rises with a castle. And that was a great challenge because we have to incorporate hydraulics, we have to incorporate steel work, and we also have to incorporate special effects that happen after the castle rises up there, right above the trees. So that's the main challenge. It's just to be a referee somehow, to kind of keep a balance between technology and art all the time.
6 weeks before the parade's debut, sound technicians are working at 3:30 in the morning on a deserted main street, equalizing the music from each float to match the acoustics of the street.
You would love to hear that. If you were my father, you would love to hear da-da-da-dum, da-da-da-dum. You're not hearing the vocals, you're just hearing the music.
Animation programmers, meanwhile, are busy choreographing their magic, adding lifelike actions to the lovable crustacean on the Little Mermaid float.
Okay, everybody!
Do you have any broad sweeping moves where he like does this and it stops and turns?
Yeah, we definitely have to use things like that.
Sebastian right now does 7 different functions animatronic-wise. That's entered initially typically on a console like this. These are his left and right arms going up and down. You've got a head nod function that goes up and down. And then all these together create the total package for Sebastian.
Well, it's certainly the most sophisticated we've done here at Walt Disney World with the quantity of animation that's on the street, on the various different units.
While drivers guide the floats along the parade route, the music, animation, and special effects are controlled from a high-tech electronic center hidden beneath the streets of the Magic Kingdom Park.
Parade 1, 30 seconds till show.
Here in a room along the famous tunnel is the electronic brain that controls the sound system and many of the audio animatronic figures at the various attractions.
Parade 1, 2 minutes step off, 2.
During the parade, each float electronically transmits its present location to this computer. In turn, the computer controls this sound mixing board, turning on and off speakers hidden in the buildings along the parade route, seamlessly matching the music amplified from each float. The digital audio control system is just one of the many departments here in Mickey's basement. The famed tunnel beneath the Magic Kingdom Park, in reality, is ground level. The Magic Kingdom was built on top. It's where Mickey and the other cast members come to pick up their costumes each day. Mickey himself has 175 different outfits, ranging from a scuba diving suit to black tie and tails. Cast members can do their banking, grab a sandwich, even get a haircut here in the tunnel. In a way, it's like a small city beneath the Magic Kingdom. Speaking of cities adjacent to the Walt Disney World Resort property, there's a new town under construction called Celebration. The first residents are moving into townhomes, cottages, village and estate homes, and apartments in six architectural styles that, when blended with the town center, create a public experience, much the same as when you walk along Main Street in the Magic Kingdom Park.
All we're doing as architects is creating a stage set, an inhabited stage set, to stimulate a sense of community, to give people the opportunity to meet each other, talk to each other, enjoy each other's company.
Respected New York architect Robert A.M. Stern is one of the key planners of Celebration. No stranger to Walt Disney World Resort projects, Stern's credentials include Disney's Boardwalk, Disney's Yacht and Beach Club resorts, and the whimsical cartoon-inspired Disney Casting Center.
What's amazing is that we got a lot of architects who, in their work outside of work for Disney, do very abstract and different kinds of work. And we got them all to agree to work within a framework of the American town.
Celebration is really Epcot, I think, in the end, in the sense of what Walt was looking for. A really nice place for people to really live real lives and have the advantages of modern technology.
We believe that has been created in Celebration. Every lesson ever learned from any master plan community in the country or throughout the world was studied in the design and development of this particular community.
We've dealt with cars in a positive way. We've dealt with garbage in a positive way, if you can say that. We've dealt with the way you live, the way you can live in a mixed-use environment with stores and apartments and houses and banks and post office all together in a walkable way. I think we're showing that you can do a new town and be respectful of the people that live there.
Coming up, raising the standards of entertainment another notch. A look at the exciting projects Disney has on the drawing boards.
It's time to remember. Here again is Regis Philbin.
25 candles on the cake, plus one to grow on. What will the next 25 years hold in store for the world's most popular vacation resort? Test Track opens next summer in Epcot as the newest edutainment attraction in Future World. Then there's the exciting new Downtown Disney area, a mix of the wildly successful Pleasure Island and Disney Village Marketplace. The area is doubling in size to include a variety of trendy new celebrity shops and restaurants. But the big focus is on spring of 1998 and the opening of Disney's Animal Kingdom, and it has everybody in the company excited.
I think the Animal Kingdom is the best idea for a new attraction, frankly, since the Magic Kingdom.
And most importantly, it's going to be a platform for us to be able to tell the important stories about wildlife conservation.
Well, he saw everything getting bigger, you know. He thought the thing growing. He warned us about that. He said, leave some room in behind some of these areas because you're going to need it for expansion. So because more and more people are going to come. He says, that's the power of a good idea, is it just grows.
Walt Disney always believed in the beauty and natural wonders of the world.
but he felt as we passed through, we should try to add a little wonder and beauty to it. 25 years ago, Walt's dream was just beginning. That dream doesn't stop here.
It's carrying on a tradition that Walt Disney established and honoring it and respecting it, but growing and experimenting with it and not being afraid to change. We could build all sorts of attractions, great thrill rides and drops and scary things, and it wouldn't matter if we lost the spirit. I'm a believer in the culture. I'm a believer in the pixie dust, and I think that is what we have to maintain. The rest will evolve naturally, but the pixie dust has to keep flowing.
On the next Live with Regis and Kathy Lee, he keeps us laughing with his constant complaining, funny guy Richard Lewis, then the sexy sounds of Kenny G. On the next Live with Regis and Kathy Lee.
Watch Live Monday at 9.
Right here on ABC 7.
Remembering the magic, the Walt Disney World Resort, the first 25 years, has been brought to you by
J&R Music and Computer World on Park Row, also celebrating their 25th anniversary.